major sports union. We will react. But first, let's talk about the Clippers. A probate judge ruled in favor of Shelly Sterling yesterday, supporting her right to sell the Clippers to ex-Microsoft CEO Steve Ballmer for $2 billion. After hearing closing arguments, Judge Michael Levanis said that Shelly Sterling had every right to sell the team and properly removed Donald Sterling as a trustee. The judge said he would review objections before issuing a written ruling. Included in Monday's ruling is a key provision in California trust law that allows Shelly Sterling to proceed with sale as if no appeal were pending. Lawyers for Shelly Sterling and Ballmer said they will try to have the sale done by August 15th.
I didn't know which way it was going to go. I just tried to do the best thing for our family and for everybody else. I think we have the best new owner that anybody could ever find. And I think it'll be even better than it was before.
Wow. A glowing endorsement there from Shelly Sterling. It appears that this will actually take place, Stephen A. So what's your take?
Well, I think it was a foregone conclusion. I think everybody expected this to happen, regardless of how ecstatic Shelly Sterling and others in the courtroom, in the packed courtroom, displayed. I think we all expected the ruling to come down the way that it did. When you consider some of the things that Donald Sterling has said on camera, on audio tape, there's one thing to have the audio tape, but then there's another thing entirely to have the interview with Anderson Cooper, where he went off on his diatribe and, implemented Magic Johnson into the discussion yet again in a very vile and disgusting manner. But then to then go forth into the courthouse, Skip, and one day he's hugging and kissing his wife, and then the very next day he's saying, "Get away from me, you pig," to his wife of over 57 years. This is what the man did. So he's all over the place, them making a case that he wasn't of sound mind and what have you because of ongoing symptoms of Alzheimer's or whatever the case may be. There just seemed to be a preponderance of evidence swelling against him. And when you couple that with the lifetime ban that Adam Silver, the commissioner of the NBA, invoked, combined with trying to really push forward to get new ownership with the Los Angeles Clippers, and then you add to all of that the fact that you spent $12 million of your money to purchase this franchise in 1981, and it's being sold for $2 billion. There was simply no reason to not ensure that this goes through. He's not losing any money. He hasn't been victimized, regardless of what anybody wants to try and say about him. He victimized himself, and it is what it is. The NBA has a right to say, "We don't want you to be a part of this fraternity." That's all they were doing here. They have every right to do that, and they gave this man nearly $2 billion to go away. I don't see how it was ever an issue, and I thought the decision was very predictable, although I anticipate it will continue to be ongoing. He'll find a way to continue to fight in the courts, but he won't be able to delay ownership being transferred to Mr. Steve Ballmer.
I agree. That is the bottom line to me here. And once we get into these legal complexities, I'm out of my league here. I've read a lot last night and this morning about how this could be dragged on and maybe on. But the bottom line is that Donald Sterling eventually, sooner or later, so now he has a team of lawyers who will continue to either file or pursue lawsuits that have already been filed. And let's think about this. If he is truly mentally incompetent, he's probably already run up staggering legal fees just in this case that just got tried. And yet his team of lawyers, I'm sure they are happily collecting their checks here, and they will happily pursue exactly. More and more lawsuits. What do they care if he's senile or not? And so you have to wonder about his decision making going forward, because he may just be a little off, a little out there, and he'll just keep suing because they all know there's a big pot of gold at the end of this rainbow that at some point he's going to lose. And when he loses,
they
guess what?
Paid.
But he wins $1 billion.
Yeah.
When he loses, he wins $1 billion. Think about that. Mm-hmm. So his team of, crack lawyers right now, they're some of the best lawyers in L.A., what do they care? They'll just keep running up the bills and trying to bleed this thing out as long as they can just realistically bleed it. And I don't know when the courts can say when, because you can't stop people from filing lawsuits. And we know how litigious Donald Sterling has always been in his past, competent or incompetent.
Well, he's incredibly litigious. He's incredibly litigious. We all know that. And you can't stop him from filing lawsuits. But the key portion of this ruling, from my understanding, and if I'm wrong, please feel free to correct me. But according to what I remember reading last night, regardless of his litigious tendencies and how he's going to continue to file lawsuits and gave his lawyers instructions to continue to fight the good fight in terms of the bevy of lawsuits he's, aimed in the direction of the NBA, that doesn't necessarily stop the sale. The sale ultimately can be done. And that's really the bottom line. So now, once that transpires, then this is simply about lawyers. This is simply about guys and an owner that doesn't want to go away, but he's going away because he's not going to have an affiliation with the NBA. And as long as that's not the case, then it doesn't affect the NBA brand. And that's what Joe Public cares about. The NBA may have a little, they may care a little bit more about it because their pockets are being endangered with his lawsuits. Others may be, may care about it because they're involved. But in terms of the players and the NBA brand, they are no longer in danger of being compromised by this man. He's gone. It's really that simple.
So give me a quick thought. How has this, in the big picture, impacted the NBA in general?
I think it's affected the NBA in a very positive way, to be quite honest with you, because we have somebody who was a slumlord, who had a sullied past and history, highly questionable to say the least. The Jemele Hills, the Bomani Jones of the world, have written about it in the past. We should have paid more attention to them when they wrote about it in the past, to be quite honest with you, in all fairness to them. But in the end, what it comes down to is that all of the things that have been attached to this man has been exposed. So number one, he's gone. Number two, it highlights some of the things that may have been going on in that fraternity of owners, because how is this man allowed to survive all of these years? I'm not saying that anybody did anything wrong, because once you're in, you're in, and if you can't get him out, what are you supposed to do? So I side with the NBA on that level. But the flip side is, you'd heard what Mark Cuban had to say, how some of his comments were interpreted. And as a result, some people are saying, well, what exactly is going on with some of you guys? Yeah. And what it's going to do is raise the eyebrows, elevate the level of awareness, and it's going to force owners to pay attention to how they present themselves and how they conduct themselves as it pertains to their relationship with players, because Donald Sterling got exposed. Mm. And now everybody's going to want to make sure that they're not lumped into the same bowl.
My only regret through this entire process is that that vote wasn't forced to be taken. Remember, everybody's going to have to vote yay or nay for Donald Sterling.
Yes.
And it never came to that, nor, and correct me if I'm wrong about this, I never heard Donald Sterling in any of his testimony start to mudsling at the other owners, try to pull other skeletons out of other closets. So the NBA avoided that public eyesore that could have been mudslinging.
I certainly don't care about the latter, Skip, because he mudslung in the direction of Magic Johnson, okay? And so what he's telling you at that moment in time, when you consider what the great Irvin Magic Johnson meant to the NBA, there's no depths to which he won't go. So I definitely believe that to some degree that would have been taken with a grain of salt, and they would have been able to move on from that, because the credibility of Donald Sterling, if for no other reason because of his questionable sanity, was going to be debunked and shoved aside, and that was going to be that.
Yep.
But I do believe that it would have been great for a vote. You remember, I was right here on this show, on these airwaves, begging for the vote to take place. Couldn't wait. I wanted it expedited. I wanted to see what owner of the 29 left was going to vote in favor of Donald Sterling maintaining ownership of the Los Angeles Clippers. When Mark Cuban had alluded to the slippery slope and what have you, I just wanted to see that with my own two eyes. I wanted to see who was going to stand up and say, I'm going to stand, even though Donald Sterling is what he is, I'm going to stand with him in terms of his him maintaining his ownership of an NBA team. Because to me, Skip, only 75% of the votes from the ownership body, the Board of Governors, was needed. But it was unacceptable to me if it was anything less than a unanimous vote.
I agree.
And I can safely say to you over these national airwaves that my sentiment, I believe, was shared by 100% of the players in the National Basketball Association. Any owner that would have stood up and voted in favor of Donald Sterling maintaining ownership of the Clippers would have had a very, very significant problem remaining in the NBA.
Didn't come to that.
All right, so you said eventually it'll get
sold.
Donald Sterling's side has 15 days to file an objection before the ruling can become final. But you made a really interesting point. If he loses, he still gets $1 billion. He still wins. If he
loses, too bad, isn't
it? It's unfortunate. If he loses, he still wins.
Only in America.
It's rich people problems. Rich people problems. Mm. All right, guys, let's move on.
Well, y'all, he didn't really do anything to lose the billion.
Yeah, this is true.
You know what I mean? Not to lose the billion he invested.
This is true. Yeah. All right.